Significant figures. So in this screencast, we're going to give a overview of how to deal with significant figures. In math class, you round differently. In science, we round using significant figures. So there's basically three parts. First, how to count significant figures. And then second, to determine the precision of a measurement. And you've done that a little bit already when you've calculated uncertainty. And then third, which is the most important part, is learn how to round to the correct number of significant figures when first you add or subtract, and then finally when multiplying and dividing. So this last third part is what we're hoping you can use the rest of the semester when we start doing math with physics. So we're going to be doing velocity calculations, acceleration calculations, and a lot of data gathering with labs too. So good luck. Okay, significant figures. In science, we round our numbers and present our numbers with a set of rules that has a lot to do with precision. Recently, you guys are doing uncertainty calculations, and involved with that was how precise is your measurement. So the next step then is to present your answer in the correct format in terms of number. Again, in math class, you may round to the 10th or 100th, but in science, we round using significant figures. And in a textbook, it's really tricky to understand this. It's really confusing. But there's an easy way to do this, and it has to do with the decimal being present or absent in a number. And then, if it's present, we're going to associate that with the Pacific Ocean being on the left. If it's absent, we're going to think of it, we're going to start counting on the right side and associate absent A for Atlantic Ocean. So that's the first thing to think about. Okay, so again, back to present, the decimal being present, that's associated with the Pacific left side, and absent Atlantic starting from the right side. So the saying is, if the decimal is present, we're going to start counting from the left, ignore zeros, till the first non-zero number, and count everything else. That's wordy, but when we actually come down here and apply it to these numbers, you'll start seeing the rhythm and how it makes sense. Absent, again, if the decimal is absent, we start counting from the right, we ignore zeros to the first non-zero and count everything else. So let's take a look at our first one. 125. Is a decimal present or absent? And you guys can, as a class, yell that out. Help out the teacher here. Present or absent? It is absent. That's right, it's absent. Here is 12.5. The decimal is present. 125,000, 1,250. Is the decimal present or absent? It is, yes, absent. And then 125,000, present or absent? It's absent. Okay, so in all these, in all these, the decimal is present. It may have, I'm not sure if this 12.5, let me clean up some things. Yeah, we do have the decimal present. Okay, so anyways, this is it, fun. Let's go through these numbers. The decimal is absent, so that means we're going to start from the right and just simply count. There's three significant figures, okay? These are easy. When there's no zeros, they're pretty easy. Second one, 12.5, the decimal is present. So we start from the left and we count 1, 2, 3. So there's three significant figures on this one. So now we get our first zero. The decimal is absent. Now check this out. If it's absent, start counting from the right. We ignore this first zero, and then we count everything else. So we ignore and then count 1, 2, 3. So in this example, there's three significant figures. We're ignoring that first zero. Same thing's gonna happen with the next one. We're gonna ignore these first three zeros, 1, 2, 3, because the decimal is absent. We start from the right, we ignore zeros, and then we count 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let's write that in. Now, all these next ones, the decimal is present, 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 present. And so if it's present up here, we're gonna start counting from the left, ignore zeros, to the first non-zero and count everything else. So what does that mean? All right, 0.4. We're going to start from the left. We're going to ignore this first zero right here and just count. So that only has one significant number. We'll let the recording catch up. 0.4 has one sig fig. Let me hit pause, ignore this zero, and we count. 1, 2. So once you start counting, you count until the end. So this zero is significant. It means that it's precise to this position. And we'll talk about that in the next slide. Okay? All right, let's see if you can get the next two on your own. I'll help talk you through it, and you write in your best guesses. Present or absent, the decimal's present. Start from the left. Ignore the first two zeros, and then count. 1, 2. Okay? Present or absent, present. Start from the left. Okay? Ignore zeros. 1, 2, 3. All these zeros can be ignored, and then you count everything else. So there's 2 sig figs and 3 sig figs. Okay, the math of sig fig. So here's some practice. You guys can use your rules to figure out the number of sig figs in this column. But the next part to that is to figure out how precise a measurement is. And that, again, remember, applies to our uncertainty calculations. Okay, so go ahead and see if you can practice your present or absent rules. So here it's absent, so we're going to start from the right, ignore zeros, and count everything else. So that's 3 sig figs. Second one, what do you think? It played too quick. So go ahead and hit pause on this video for a second and see if you can figure out the sig fig columns for the rest of these numbers. Here, all the decimals are present. So you're going to ignore zeros starting from the left and then count everything else. And in this column here, the decimal is present or absent. Oh, here it is present. So you're going to start from the left and count. Okay. And here come the answers. See how you did. So just to talk out loud on this one. Present, start from the left, ignore the first two zeros, count 1, 2, 3, 4. If you think about it, if this were a digital scale, that's an extremely accurate scale. It's measuring to the tenth, hundred thousandths, ten thousandths, hundred thousandths. So you pay a lot of money to get a lot of sig figs, or you measure something big. Okay? Okay, the math of sig figs continued. So the next step in significant figures, once you've figured out how many sig figs there are, is you can figure out how precise this value is. So you've done this already with the lab and the worksheets that we've worked on, but we want to now connect it to significant figures. So 321, the most precise significant number, is this 1. So what's here in red, the step or the precision, those are used interchangeably, is the most precise significant number. In other words, the one that's furthest to right that you counted as significant. So again, when there's no zeros, it's easy. So this second one, 3.21, it's accurate to the hundredth. Let's go ahead and drag this up too. The first one is precise to the ones position. So taking a look at this one, there's 4 sig figs. We started from the left and we counted every single one. So this zero here is significant. So it's accurate to the 0.001. That's the precision of the measurement. All right, this one's tricky. Number 4, slow down and think. Again, let's read the red. The most precise significant number, in other words, the furthest one to the right that was counted. So remember, the decimal was absent here. So we ignored this zero. So this one is the first number we counted that's significant. So I didn't have a number 10 connected here or ready to go. So let me change this number to 10. This number is precise to the tens value because we ignored that zero. Using that train of thought, 32,100, we ignored these first two zeros. So right here, the precision is the 100s. So do a quick copy paste, drag this down, and add a zero. Okay. The rest of these are pretty simple because they're all decimals. And anytime there's a decimal, it's easier to see the precision of the measurement. Here, we ignored this zero, but counted this one. So that 0.7 is in the 10th position. So if you want, hit pause in the video and see if you can fill in 1, 2, 3, 4, the last four. And I'll wait for a sec, and then we'll pick it up. Okay, so the second one, number 7, is precise to the 100th, because it's this 7 we counted. You might be tempted to say 0.01 or the 100th again, but we did count this 0. So it's accurate to the thousandth. And what I like to say is, man, if we had a digital scale that measured to the thousandth decimal place, we probably as a department need to spend like $800, $600 for that scale. So I'm going to show that off. I'm going to say, look, I'm going to write this zero. In math class, the teacher will say, look, 0.07, that's the same thing as 0.070, still, you know, 7/100. But in science, it's important we put that because that tells you how precise a measurement you made. Okay, number 9, it's precise to the 10th, 100 thousandths, 10 thousandths. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3 zeros. And then this last one probably won't even fit. Okay, there you go.